Hello, my dear students. Our lesson today about vertical motion under the effect of the gravity or free fall. At the first, if the body is falling or projected downwards. Since the body, which is moving vertically freely, have a uniform acceleration. Its magnitude is the gravity acceleration, 9.8 meter per second squared. Then we can apply the same laws of motion at a straight line, by replacing A by G. Then the equations are V equal V naught plus GT, replace A by G. And the second equation, S equal V naught T plus half GT squared. Third equation, V squared equal V naught squared plus 2GS. For example, a body is fall vertically downwards from a height of 44.1 meter above the ground. Find the velocity of the body after 1 second. First required, find the velocity after 1 second from the moment of falling. Then find the time taken to reach the ground, and also find the velocity when it reaches the ground. First, we need to find the velocity of the body after 1 second. Then V naught equal 0. V naught equal 0, and the gravity acceleration G equal 9.8 meter per second squared. And height equal 44.1 meter. To find the velocity after 1 second, number one, V equal V naught plus GT. Therefore, V equal V naught 0 plus G 9.8 times time 1 second after 1 second. Therefore, equal 9.8 meter per second. Velocity after 1 second is 9.8 meter per second. Second required, find the time taken to reach the ground. Time to reach the ground, distance, instead of the second equation, S equal V naught T plus half G T squared. Therefore, S is the height of the 44.1 equal V naught 0 times T equal 0 and half times 9.8 G times T squared. Therefore, T squared equal 44.1 divided 9.8 times half if as therefore time using calculator time equal square root number that I couldn't came 3 seconds. Time to taken to reach the ground is 3 seconds. Third required, the velocity when the body reaches the ground. The body takes 3 seconds to reach the ground. Then the velocity V equal V naught plus GT. Therefore, V equal 0 plus 9.8 times 3. V equal 29.8 4 meter per second. The velocity is 29.4 meter per second. Second case, if the body is projected upwards, when the body projected downwards, then the acceleration is positive, and acceleration is negative when the body is projected upward. Then the equations are V equal V naught minus GT, because the acceleration, gravity acceleration is negative, therefore the equation will be V naught minus GT, the first equation when the body is projected upward, and S equal V naught T minus half GT, the second equation, and the third equation V squared equal V naught squared minus 2GS, the third equation. Example. A body is projected vertically upwards with velocity of 24.5 meter per second. Find the maximum height. The first required is the maximum height that the body reach, and the time taken to reach the maximum height. Find also the time taken to from the maximum height to reach the point of projection, and what is the velocity at the point of projection. Many requires in this example. The first required is the maximum height. Maximum height, the body reach the maximum height, its velocity will be zero. Therefore, maximum, when maximum height, the velocity is a zero. Velocity will be zero at maximum height. Velocity will be zero. Okay, and the initial velocity V naught equal 24.5 meter per second. Therefore, V squared equal V naught squared minus 2GS. Therefore, 0 equal V naught squared 24.5 squared minus 2 times 9.8 times S. Therefore, S equal 30.625 meter approximately is the maximum height. Or we can use at maximum height, S equal at max height, S equal V node squared over 2G equal 24.5 power 2 over 2 by 9.8. We take the same answer of the maximum height. Second required, the time taken to the maximum height, time taken, and the time taken equal time to reach maximum height equal 24.5 over 9.8 divide equal 2.5. and time equal time هيكون في الحالة دي equal إيه V node over G. Equal 2.5 seconds. Okay. Find the time taken from the maximum height to reach the point of projection. To reach the maximum height, then the body turn back to the point of projection. It takes the same time. يبقى time to going back to the maximum from the point of projection equal 2.5. 2.5. And the velocity, velocity to reach the same point or the point of projection is the point is the initial velocity. V naught equal 24.5 meter per second. Then the velocity to turn back to the point of projection equal 24.5 meter per second. Another example. A small stone is projected vertically upwards with velocity 19.6 meter per second from a top of a tower of height. Height of the tower is 156.8 meter from the ground. Find the time elapsed from the moment of projection till it reach the ground surface. Number two, the velocity of the body when reaching the ground surface. Body projected from top of tower. Tower of height at 156 meter and turned back to reach the ground surface. Then, from the body to the ground surface, the height equal 156.8 meter. Okay? We can consider the direction of upward is a positive direction. Moving upward is a positive direction. Then, when the body reaches the ground, S equal negative 156.8 meter because it's turned back, okay, in the opposite direction. Plus, therefore, to find the elapsed time, we use the second equation. S equal V naught T minus half g t squared, therefore negative 156.8 equal v naught equal 19.6 times t minus half 9.8 times t squared. Move right, therefore 4.9 t squared minus 19.60 plus 156.8 equals 0. To simplify, therefore, t squared minus 4t minus 32 equals 0. We can factorize it. T 32 is 4 by 8, negative 8 plus 4. Therefore, t equal 8 or t equal negative 4. طبعاً ده refused ما ينفعش. Time negative is refused. Then, the time taken to reach the ground surface is 8 seconds. 8 seconds. Second required, the second required, how to find the velocity of the body when reaching the ground surface. Number two, to reach the ground surface, then V velocity equal V equal V naught minus GT. V equal V naught 19.6 minus G 9.8. And the time, this has been a time times 8, which equal negative 58.8 meter per second. Negative because in the opposite direction we take the positive direction in the motion upward. Then the velocity to reach the ground equal 58.8 meter per second downward. Okay, that's enough. Thank you very much.